So this is going to be at the end. And then you want to put on the side.
I'm about to go make a bracelet right now.
What is it? Okay, so you got yours. So have you decided what you want to just send in? Center V. That's gonna be the end. Your
palm
is always the end.
This one.
This one is your charm. So that's gonna hang down.
Oh, hang down. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yep. All right. So I'll do that. Can this be the middle?
Yeah. That's
okay.
hang up.
I'm gonna stand over here.
What?
Oh, I love your earrings. They're beautiful. Somebody have Angel on. Angel, Terry Moogler. Okay, I know Angel. My mom put me on to that. The other side.
I did the same thing. I was ending myself away from these. But then I went to go, and all of a sudden all the beads were
all the beads on the waist.
All the beads, a lot. And they were itty itty bitty. So I was sitting there with the little thing and put them on. And then I had to forget it. And then I was going to do the job.
Thank you.
Okay. All you can do is go to those basic healthy habits. Having, generally speaking, the plate version for people with diabetes tends to work well for people who are trying to manage their weight as well.
So I need to do that one.
So it's basically half of your plate being non-starchy vegetables.
Okay.
A quarter of your plate being protein and a quarter of your plate being healthy sources of carbohydrates.
Okay.
So grains, fruits, starchy vegetables.
Okay. So I got my plate.
Oh, you got my plate.
What's that mean?
True or false?
Okay.
The dietary guidelines for Americans recommend eating all of your grains as whole grains.
All of the grains is whole grains.
Yes.
True.
It is not.
Oh!
They
oh,
actually okay. only recommend
a portion.
Half.
So
half.
The other one's whole
the
and
other
then...
Half, you can have some regular refined grains if you
really?
Want to. More is not bad. It gets you extra fiber.
Okay.
The recommendation technically is only half.
Okay, so half
it's
grains
easier.
And half refined grains. Half and half. It's okay.
All right. Next time.
What snack would you like?
This wasn't healthy. No.
Corn.
No.
Corn actually is counting as a whole grain.
Okay, I'll try it. Okay. All right. Thank you.
Safe and beneficial. So where does this myth come from? All right, technical stuff at a really, really high level. Some cancers are hormone sensitive, and estrogen is one of those hormones. Soy contains something that is called phytoestrogens, more specifically a specific variety called isoflavones. Now, phytoestrogens are not the same as estrogens. They have some similarities, but over time, with more research, what we've learned is that phytoestrogens do not act the same way in our body as estrogens, and they do not bind to those estrogen receptors in the same way that estrogen does. So studies across populations have suggested that eating soy foods can even be protective against breast cancer and cancer recurrence. Now there's a
So I'm here at the breast cancer event with Yanni.
Hello.
And she's going to do my lashes. She's going to make me look beautiful. Ready?
Oh, and I just got my bracelet done. Thank you, boo.
You want to slide it on for me? Thank you. Ooh, made me feel beautiful again. Oh, I love it. Thank you. All right.
All right. So do you start out with down? Say you become a rib. I'll
help you. Should I take the eyeliner off? Oh, no.
Yeah. I love your thing.
Sorry, I'm excited to be at BMW.
Okay, I was going to say, Janice,
and look down to the ground. Open look down. Like, no, yeah, perfect. Don't
look at the BMW.
Yeah, instead of the two of them, they're like, okay, Wanda. And they're like, what's this? And I was like, she's like, okay. And then I get here and I'm like, okay, I got it.
You wish I knew how to do these things. I tried and I tried.
One day I'll
figure it out.
Yeah, and once you get it, you get it. But yeah, it takes that getting stage. You gotta tell me what they are. She's like, they
identify. It's funny because they're like. So tell me what stars you work for.
I work with Vivica Fox, Just Hilarious, Princess Love, Megan Good.
Nice.
The old Aunt Viv, One Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
Oh. the black
Jason
one.
Weaver. Yeah, no, the light one. No, the newer one, I meant. The newer.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Jason Weaver.
Jason Weaver. Who else have I worked with? Open real quick.
Okay. Who is your favorite celebrity to work with?
My favorite was definitely, I worked with Sheena Arnold too as well.
Really?
Yeah.
Open
again. Do you feel like they're glued together? Or do you feel like they're love?
Something feels like maybe you shouldn't feel it.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know.
You just gotta adjust a little bit.
Oh, okay. You know, I'm not a beauty girl. I'm on the go all the time. I wish. I'm always on the go.
So pretty. My favorite's probably Jess Hilarious. I love Jess Hilarious.
Oh, yeah, she's funny. Yeah. She is. She's a mess.
She's really
Baltimore, good. Baltimore.
Yeah.
Oh, you are fast. Thank you. I love them. So are these me?
They are.
I don't know anything about lashes. I got some in my closet just sitting there waiting.
Well, you gotta use them now.
But I'm always on the go. I have like 3 jobs. I'm in grad school.
Okay.
Put a treatment every 3 months.
Okay.
Got a demanding job.
I understand.
And yeah, I'm always in sneakers.
Well, you look beautiful.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Yanni.
Nice meeting you.
Nice meeting you. Makes me feel beautiful. Thank you, boo.
Ticket number 131.
Ticket number 131.
131.
I don't even know.
All right, come on up.
Comedy meets go-go.
Okay.
I think so.
Oh, right, was it good?
Thank
you.
Okay, you guys still listening? Yeah. Okay, good stuff. All right, ticket number 141 for a giant gift card. $50 giant gift card. 141. Ticket 141.
Where is this card?
141. All right, here we go. Thank you. All right, yes. She just had her first surgery. Let's give her a round of applause.
Yay!
Blessings, blessings. All right, this is for another pair of tickets to see Where Comedy Meets Go-Go at the Lincoln Theater. Again, it's on this coming Sunday at 7 p.m.
Oh, is this Sunday?
You're about to take it already?
No, not for that. No. What is it for?
For 2 nights stay at the hotel.
Ooh. Engagement, the community. Oh, okay, you keep going. Oh, keep talking. Oh, it's a video.
If you don't mind.
Yes, no, so, yes, with our faith-based group, we do a lot of outreach and partnering to have add value to events that churches do with their health ministries, but also partnering with hospitals to help the chemo patients be more comfortable to have somewhere to go. And we just have a lot of resources. We like to educate based on the lens of the black experience. As you know, they tell black people, everybody, the age is 40 for a lot, like prostate cancer too. It's really 35 for us. And that goes back to not being represented in clinical trials.
Yeah, it's awful, isn't it?
But there's a reason why. So we're just trying to, like, you know, come in with some honesty when we have these educational pieces, especially talking to Prince George's County and realizing that the rate of death is higher here in Prince George's. That's because they're not getting screened.
Yep, the mammograms. Yeah, we're not going, women of color aren't going.
Yeah.
But white women are diagnosed.
Yeah, because they're just, but they know. They know, and that's a huge part of it. It's like, we have to, you know, not be afraid of finding out.
Right,
you know,
right. Oh, it hurts.
Knowledge is power.
Yeah.
We have to know.
Yeah, I have a girlfriend right now. I met her in 7th grade. You know, we're in our mid-40s now, and she said she's never had a mammogram. She said her doctor does the...
Yeah, but she gotta go have the... I'm like, okay, I gotta schedule mine. I'm 35.
Yeah, she said, nope. Yeah. She's not interested in it, so I was like, okay.
And you gotta change the narrative, and like the way that we approach it.
She's like,
if I don't think about it, it's not going to happen to me, that type of thing. Like, it's nothing wrong.
I'm guilty of that too.
Yeah.
But like, working here is kind of like...
Open your eyes up.
35. Really?
Yeah. Yeah. There's nothing wrong. It's painless to get a screening versus two. Yeah. Yeah. Yep. Well, thank you.
Might be too late.
I know, God forbid. And I just talked to my coworker, and her mom was diagnosed in 2016. And today I went over there, and she was asking me about my treatment. And I was like, yeah, it's going. You know, the side effects are a bummer, but I'm here to tell about it. But her mom, I found out from her that the cancer came back, and the doctor was telling her that it spread, and she said she doesn't want to do chemo. So I just gave her a hug, and I prayed with her. And I was like, you know what?
We've got a support group for that too.
You
like,
do?
Life support group.
Okay.
Like with people who are deciding that that's, you know, not deciding.
Yeah.
But either know that it's that or you're deciding, no,
yeah.
I'm going to just kind of.
What's the name of that group?
I think it's called a late stage or.
Okay.
Or, I don't know. But it's definitely.
Okay.
You have to sound
good. No, I'm talking with you, and I haven't done anything yet. Okay, what's in this goodie bag? Okay, thank you so much. I appreciate you. What's your name again?
I'm Cicely.
All right, Cicely. That's a pretty name. Thank you. All right, well, this is Cicely with the Hope Connections, and you heard it first. Get your mammogram, ladies.
Yes.
I don't care what you heard. It's better to go get screened than not. Do it now. Do it today. I don't care if you're a little bit under 40. Do it anyway. Because I'm here as a living proof that you can still live. I'm still in treatment. Yes, I gained 40 pounds, but I'm here to live and tell about it. And me and my mom are survivors. So thank you for watching. Get your life more abundant. Bye.
Bye.
1 There's this thing about making stuff for my oncologist's office for the new diagnosed women. So I gotta find some small ones to make.
What you can do is add your fragrance now and later. You know what I mean? Like, I'm sorry, when I say later, I mean after you sort it. So you can add it now.
Okay.
And then pour it and add more.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna do eucalyptus. How many drops?
I'm gonna do about 4 or 5.
Okay.
It's okay. You'll be able to move it again.